A big hello and a warm welcome to all of you amazing and beautiful people out there. Welcome to my channel, The Twin Flame Union. In this channeling session, I would be talking about a divine masculine and a divine feminine who have gone through a very difficult and intense time of karmic entanglement, wherein both of them in their own way and in their own situations have learned a very big lesson. And they have sort of come back to each other after going through all of these difficulties. From the masculine's perspective, he was quite into the feminine. The feminine was quite into the masculine. But they never really trusted the relationship and they never really trusted the love they had for each other. Or you could say that their blocks were very strong. Their programming was very strong. And the masculine always thought that, you know, he needs to live his life in a certain way. He needs to do things in a certain way. And he was very much influenced by his family members, his parents' decision making. He was very much influenced by the adults in his life. And he was always depending on them. Always depending on them to know, to ask, like, what should I do, what would be correct, and this and that. His own inner guidance system was weak at that point in time. And the feminine, who had to take most of the decisions, the contrary, the opposite, the feminine had to take most of the decisions for her family, right from taking care of them, to upkeeping them, to spending for them, to earning for them, being a responsible person, okay? So what really happened is that she was taking all the decisions since a very young age, even for the adults in her life. So when it came to her relationships, when it came to her happiness, she obviously decided to keep it behind because she felt that, you know, if she's going to leave them or settle down or be with another person, fall in love with another person, like outside of the family, as a partner, it's okay to be in a relationship just for some time. It's okay to date someone, it's okay to be boyfriend, girlfriend, and this and that. But if she has to leave the people who depend on her, then it won't be okay for her. That's how she felt. She was scared to do that. She thought that she is the parent of all those adults, so she needs to look after them. They are her responsibility. So it's a very opposite sort of a dynamic going on. In one place, the man is not able to make any decisions. Even though he's an adult, he is still being seen as a child, or he's behaving like a child who needs the guidance of other people, step-by-step guidance of other people all the time. And the feminine is somebody who is literally sort of step-by-step, you know, guiding other people, where she is nowhere in the picture. And those people are also very selfish, that they don't think about her. They always put their situations and problems and needs in front of her. Like, literally forgetting that she could also have a life. She could also fall in love. She could also want to buy something, do something, go somewhere, have some dreams and desires. For them, she is just a slave who's supposed to please them all the time. But the manipulation, or the, you can say, dependence is so high that she also feels good about it. She also feels like, you know, she has some kind of a responsibility. She is somewhere in a good position because, you know, when some people want to get things done from someone, they are not going to be bad towards that person. They will be nice towards that person as long as their needs are getting fulfilled. So that's the situation she was in. The masculine on the other side is literally, I can say this is like man and woman thing. Energetically, it's a feminine who's a provider, and it's a masculine who's a nurturer. You can say it like that. So energetically, there is this type of a dance where one person is burdened with responsibility. The one person had to be an adult at a very young age, and the other person is still living like a child, you know, still not out of their shell, still not out of their cave, the cave of the, you know, like in animals, they have a cave and the children are within the cave till the time they don't learn the skills of hunting the food and things like that. But once they do, then they also have to go out in the woods. So this masculine is not being trained or purposely, because yes, they feel like, you know, he should be doing everything as per them, or he has to fulfill some kind of demands, or he has to fulfill some kind of thing. It's like he's an extension of their ego. He's an extension of everything that they think. It's not like he says, you know what, I want to travel because I want to travel. So here also you can see that his actual emotions, real emotions, are being totally ignored, you know, put behind the back burner. He's not important, even though it may seem like, it may look like that he's very important. So there is inadequacy of love and there is imbalance of love right there, because one person is becoming an adult way before their time and still playing that role, and the other person, despite being an adult, is not being able to grow, still being seen like a child, you know, who needs other people's help. He has to please other people. So while the masculine chooses to hurt the feminine and run away from the feminine because he feels, or he felt, that she would be someone who's not going to be helpful in this. You know, maybe her decision making was not in sync with him because she was not ready for it, according to him. She feels that she cannot take up another responsibility, another big responsibility, because when two people come together in a typical scenario, in a three-dimensional scenario, they want to have marriage and then they want to have children and maybe one children, more than one children. So it's like increasing the family. And she already has so many family members to take care of, or so many people to take care of. And I'm talking about the time when they are unhealed, when they are both wounded. Because when they are wounded, they are very much stuck in the limited number of people who they are serving to, basically like a slave, the slavery energy. Once they start doing inner work, they realize that this whole planet is a family and the life they have over here is temporary, and they are not here to serve people, they are here to serve God. They are here to serve Source. Whatever Source has sent them to do over here, they are supposed to do it here. And every single person is responsible for themselves. And as long as they are adults, they should live like adults. If they are children, they should live like children. If there are wounds, an adult person who is wounded, their inner child is wounded, then they need to fix the inner child, you know, heal the inner child, so that the adult and the inner child can perform together. You are the person, you are the same person who's supposed to take care of your own inner child. That's the thing that they understand. They both understand this. And as I always say, that it's the feminine who enters the healing phase first. She's the one who gets awakened first. And I'm not talking about specifically a person feminine or a gender feminine. I'm talking about feminine energy. Within the two energies, the two polar energies, masculine and feminine, it's always feminine energy that awakens first. A masculine follows. It's the feminine for whom Source is everything. Source is the true lover. And for the masculine, it's the feminine who's the true lover. So it's like the lover's card in tarot deck, tarot cards. So now what's happening over here is both of them had their huge karmic struggles have been shown. The feminine had to, you know, take care of worse characters, very narcissistic characters, who literally, like, you know, they are babies, they need a mother. Basically, they have a mother, but when they look at a life partner, they treat her like a mother. They want the mother to, you know, constantly look after them, feed them. You know, like, they're crying constantly, they're complaining, or they are demanding all the time something or the other, like a child, you know, wants to change the nappy. And I'm talking about a cranky child, I'm not talking about a happy child here. So those type of relationships. And the masculine has to be with people who are liars, who overcommit, or who commit way too much, but they never, you know, keep up those promises. They never keep up to their words. So he ends up meeting those type of karmics which generate the adult in him. or I would say generate the energy of the adult in him. He meets people who he has to baby, who he has to nurse, who he has to look after. And he meets people who are extremely spoiled and extremely good in acting. So he gets to know that there are big time liars, you know, when it comes to his karmic experience. He feels very cheated, very betrayed, and suddenly he grows up because he realizes that his people, all the people who are making decisions for himself, they are not good decision makers. They don't keep him or his feelings in the priority. When he tells them that, you know, I'm going through pain and I'm suffering and I'm miserable, they don't say anything. They just tell him to, you know, keep suffering or keep going through it. But when they get insulted or when they get humiliated, then they are like, okay, let's do something. But it obviously is not for the masculine. It's for themselves only. And he realizes this with time. And then on the feminine side also, she feels that she ends up meeting people who bring out the child in her. Obviously, both of them go through negative experiences, but that brings out something that was blocked within them. So she wants to be happy. She wants to be carefree. She doesn't want to take care of anyone. She feels that, why should I baby people? I'm a baby right now. You know, I'm the baby here. I'm the one who needs the babying or the looking after or the pampering or the caretaking or whatever. So I don't want to be with a man who wants me to, you know, like take care of him all the time. So in a different way, like in the other side, we see that the adult is coming out from the baby. And here the baby is coming out from the adult. So it's interesting. This dynamic is very interesting. So she's like, no, I don't want to be with anyone who wants me to be this way. And then she realizes in her support system, why is this happening? Why is everyone demanding, expecting her? If she is in a physically abusive relationship, then too she realizes that she's getting physically abused. She's getting tortured because she does not want to be a mother to someone. And she's saying, if I really have to be a mother to someone, then I might as well be a mother to someone who really needs me. Why this grown-up man, you know, why this grown-up man, why his mother, why his father, why his sister, why are they expecting me to nurse him all the time? So when she goes to support, for support to her people, they also tell her the same thing. They say, no, it's okay. Because they are doing the same thing to her. They've constantly been making her take care of them. So what's new? You know, they are like, so what? They literally support the person who is torturing her. Okay. So she gets very hurt, and both of them get hurt actually because of their karmic situations. Both of them get very hurt, and slowly and gradually they realize that we don't want to do anything with anyone. You know, nobody is really true and real. Nobody is really there for me as such when I need them. So it is painful. Obviously it is sad. It is upsetting for both of them to be in a situation like this. But technically, they had to go through this experience only to come back to each other. When they come back to each other, they are sort of healing each other this time. You know, they are putting medicine on their wounds. They are applying some balm, or they're giving some relief to each other. They are holding each other. They are like, you know, I am with you. I'm there for you. Okay. I know we were happier. We were much happier when we were together, but we did not know that we belong to each other. We had to go through these experiences, you know, this and that. They talk about it and they realize, you know, they come to terms with this truth that they love each other. They need to be with each other, not, you know, not those people who don't care. But then, as I said, the harmonization is not an easy process either. We all think that everything is always easy peasy for people, but it's not. But the thing is that by the time people reach harmonization, they've realized that they've actually done a lot. You know, you can measure your growth. You can measure that you were in a very dark place, but now you're not. So that itself gives you the courage to get into the phase of harmonization, because after such a long break, after such a long separation, when two people are coming together, it's not really easy because they had their own baggage too. When they went their separate ways, they also had some issues that were unresolved. And those unresolved issues, they maybe went into karmic partners, karmic relationships, and then they realized that, after so many karmic relationships, maybe for one person it was only one karmic relationship, but a very long-term karmic relationship. And for the other one, it was multiple karmic relationships, different types of karmic relationships happened. And then they realized that, I'm just not into any of this. I don't want to get into any of this nonsense. This is really atrocious. This is a torture. This is not love. This is torture in the name of love. So I don't want to do this. The other person also, the one who's in a long-term relationship, also feels the same thing. Like, I went into such a with such a big bang, I went to it with such a joy and so many preparations and celebrations. I went into something, but it was literally useless, worthless, and it was so painful. So their pain has actually been their teacher in this case. So now they are trying to harmonize with each other. They're trying to figure things out, and the problem of the families is still there. They might have been not so dependent on them. They might have changed a lot. They might have started creating boundaries, but they need to create fuller, more stronger boundaries now. So the harmonization phase is going to help them out to do so. So for your personal situation, you can check out the description box, as in for your personal sessions, therapies, inner work, counseling, hand-holding. There are many options. You can check out whichever resonates with you. The only request is that kindly do not share your twin flame journey in advance with me. You can share it during the session, during the personal session, if you take a reading. If you take therapy, then please be prepared to work on yourself during therapy. Therapy is something where we do assignments. We do some fun assignments, we do some information exchange, we talk to each other because we need to find out where are the trauma bonds. There are homework assignments are there, so you need to be prepared for that. You need to be ready. If you are still addicted, if you cannot let go of some major addictions, then maybe you can get into therapy, but you also need to figure out that, or you need to accept that, yes, I am addicted to certain things. And these are the addictions that put you in separation mode, to be honest. And for those people who cannot afford a personal session, or they cannot afford a therapy right now because of root chakra blocks, then you guys should join the channel as a member, and then you can unlock the live sessions, the live streams, the live readings, the live Q&A, and there are many videos that are timeless readings also. So whenever you check it out, it will fall true for you. It would be resonating with you. It should resonate with you. If it doesn't, then there are many options in the live streams actually, which will be open to all the members, which is open to all the members. Those who subscribe to the channel, they are the ones who get access to the live streams, because initially when we start the live stream, we don't immediately put it into the members only group. So either you should be a subscriber who is always working on themselves and ready for the channel's updates and notifications, or you should join the channel so that you can get access to it regularly and also get to keep referring back to them. Just in case you watch it once and you feel like, oh, I want to watch it again. Or maybe there is something about the chakras that you want to study. And also this feature allows you to get some content which is only for the members. So there is free content, there is member-only content, there is content for people who are in therapy, and there is work for people who are in therapy, and there is also personal sessions to help you out. So there's so much happening here, and this is the inner work that you can do with me. And personally also you can do your own inner work so that you can ascend in the twin flame journey. Now, one thing I would like to say, that whatever situation you are in, you must remember one thing, a very important thing, is to surrender. If you are not going to surrender to your true feelings, then this process is going to become very long for you and also painful for you. So on this note, I'll sign out from this particular session. Thank you so much for being here with me. Thank you for doing all the amazing inner work you're trying to do. One love and peace out.